Welcome back, my friend! I have some exciting updates for you on the process of my game development journey. It's been a while since our last chat, but I guarantee you won't regret sticking around for this one. So, buckle up and get ready for a wild ride! In the previous video, we decided to focus on two critical elements of the game – environment element and enemies. But, as you know, nothing worth having comes easy, and boy, did we have our work cut out for us. First off, I had to lay groundwork for the environment to stand on. We had some empty fields on the sides of our screen, which we cleverly hid by adjusting the terrain width and playing with the camera settings. It was a challenge to remember everything I've done since I had 2 week pause in developing, but rediscovering everything was a pleasure. To make road prefab, I followed this 4-step process. First, I created an empty road prefab. Second, I made a plane with a texture to be our road tile, and I seen it as a child for this road prefab empty. Third, I added another empty as a spawn point for the next tile at the other end of the plane. Fourth, I added 6 spawn empties for obstacles or enemies that would appear with a certain chance depending on the game difficulty. I also added a chance to spawn from 2 to 10 coins, which would appear randomly within our road tile. Once I got the road prefab working, I instantiated 10 road tiles at the beginning to fill the camera fields of view. As the game started and the player moved forward, I destroyed the tile behind the player and instantiated a tile in front of them as the player left the current tile. But the real goal of this video was to fill the space on both sides of our road with terrain and surroundings. In other words, we needed to add environment elements to make everything look more realistic. I added another tile under the road, which would serve as a terrain, and added spawn points for buildings, and boy, that was a challenge. I had to make sure that the building spawns correctly, fix the spawn point by height, and deleted overlapping buildings. It was a serious adult BDSM game role-playing moment. So much pain to make it work. By the way, speaking of people who bring the pain into our life, let's talk about Russia. As you know, I live in Ukraine, and Russia has started a brutal war in my country, occupying part of the territory and spreading terror and death everywhere its occupants appear. I ask you to consider contributing to Ukraine's fight against the pure evil in the form of Russia by donating to Shell Donator. We will write your text on a mortal shell that will bring your message directly to the Russian's head. It's my personal project, and I personally supervise that all proceeds will go to the purchase of cars, equipment, and auto parts for military personnel who I know personally. Check out the Shell Donator Facebook page for reports. After some hard times making the building spawn correctly, I moved forward with the wobbling camera. Without buildings on the sides, I didn't notice that the camera shook so badly. I had to do something about it. To solve this issue, I increased the time of the camera to reach its planned position, which smooths out the cam movement a lot and make the shaking almost invisible. And then 3D artist reaches me and offered to help me to create a unique models for this game, so we might see those models in the future series. I was ecstatic. This means that I would have more time to focus on other things and the game would look even better with unique 3D models. And that wasn't only thing I managed to fix. I also made a ragdoll active on the game over, of course. I couldn't leave it activated on the press of enter, it wasn't make any sense. So I had to manage this issue and make sure that the ragdoll was enabled correctly. It wasn't easy, but I managed to do it my way. And the result was better than I imagined. To make things even better, I decided to make a camera look at the player on death. This small challenge made a huge difference and made the game look even more appealing. I tried a couple of approaches and surprisingly, it wasn't as hard as I thought it would be. By making the transition from normal camera mode to game over mode, the gameplay looked much smoother and the effect was stunning to me. And that's it for today. I'm pleased with the current results and I hope you enjoy this journey with me. Please support me with your likes, subs and comments, because as you can see, developing a game is not an easy feat. We'll meet again in the next part of my story, and I can't wait to see you there.